I drove 4 miles and miles and wound up at your door. I've had you so many times, but so
we're back. Oh, thank you, Mark 2000, for following. Let's turn up the music a little bit. Okay. Let me know if my what's it called? Music or my voice is too quiet. Because either one is possible. Never know. Let's do an audio mixer. Should be fine, right? I'm just really quiet. I don't mean any. I'll try to speak louder. I'll sit up. Always helps with projection. There we go. Woo. Maybe we should turn it down a bit so it's easy. We turn it up so that by nature I'm louder. Let's pull it up on my phone and we'll listen to me. And then we'll decide if it's super loud. Okay? Sound like a plan? So let's talk. Okay, I think I'm really loud. Is this okay? Sorry, you can hear me in my own mic. It's great. If you're in the Discord server or if you're somewhere else. but the theme of this stream isn't gonna be quite as upbeat as the others, because the goal is to just for this one it's just to talk about happy things I love, things that have changed, things that are hard, what I've been up to, is just all of it. And it's been a while since I did that, so I don't know. Do let me know if my voice is too loud or too quiet. Oh, okay, thank you. This works. Turn it up a bit. Yay! It's because I'm a quiet person, so when I'm talking alone in a room, I'm a bit quieter. There we go. Is that better? Do let me know what I was saying before that. Essentially, it's just talking, getting things caught up, understanding everything that's happening, all of it. It's gonna be great. Hopefully you enjoy it, and hopefully this helps people catch up to everything that's happening, you know? Just see what happens. So, the plan is just start wearing comfortable. Sorry. Well, for me at least, I'm just a quiet person. I don't know if I can help with that. But it also could be the fact that I'm fairly quiet. Like, my mic is. It's okay. Yeah. should be fine, right? You can hear me? Everything's going well? Check, check. Okay. Let's actually start the stream now. It's been a hot minute. But it should be fine. Okay. So, the just talking part. Okay. One of the biggest changes has happened. I mean, there's been a lot that changed. Apart from just my physical appearance. Me becoming more... well... confident. Finding myself again. Being able to do these things is... it's important to me. Especially being able to talk to all of you like I do now is just crazy. So, let's start with the biggest change that probably all of you are sick of hearing about. Jay. Now let's start from the beginning. The very beginning. I didn't meet Jay first. I met his sister, whose name is Liliana, but we called her Lily. I met her in middle school. We were both in honors choir together. We were nerds. Very, very pre-glow up, you know? I was chubby and crazy and energetic and all over the place and a mess. Who didn't know what was going on? And she was a dog who would dance when there was no music, which I do now, which is kind of ironic. She loved anime, had these huge glasses, and always had her hair back in a low ponytail, which was not flattering for her face shape. Very tomboyish. I was extremely weird. I've always had a weird sense of fashion. But we got to know each other, we became friends, right? And then she ended up moving. So, not very far, but at the time I thought she like moved. She just moved middle schools, and that was about 7th grade. I lost contact with her, of course, because it was 7th grade. She didn't have a phone yet, and my phone was a flip phone. But I eventually finished middle school, went on to high school, and then we reconnected when I joined the musical. So she got cast as like a higher role, I got cast as a supporting role, and then I got promoted into like a lead position, which was insane. But because of my medical problems, I ended up having to leave the musical, which wasn't great. But in that time, when we were practicing for the musical and getting to know each other again, becoming friends again, I went to her house more often. We hung out. And I met her brother. She has two brothers. So the first one I met was her little brother, who is, I think he's 12 now? That's insane. He was very little. And he will forever be like 6 in my mind, even though he was older than 6 when we met. But then their older brother, at the time was their older sister. And her name was Jane. She was a rebel. Everything that Lily wasn't, she was cool. Keep in mind that Lily and I had quote unquote glow ups by then, but we would continue to get better. She was just cool, seemed sort of uncomfortable, but in general, it was just a whole new world. This person, a year older, and yet everything seemed to be figured out. A year and a half, so it's all over the place. So, of course, I got a crush. I didn't say anything about it. It's embarrassing to talk about this, and it's been so long that I don't know how to put the words together. But eventually, right, I had been in choir with Lily, so he had us singing, and he loved my voice, absolutely loved it, and he invited me to sing with his friends, a couple guys and girls and non-binary friends who just really were passionate about their music, and they didn't particularly sing, they had one that's actually sang, the rest of them played instruments, and they were thinking about forming a band, but they weren't sure of themselves, and they didn't want to start something that would fail, you know? So, it was then that Jane started to realize what was making them so uncomfortable and gain that confidence. And by that point, I was almost closer friends with Jane than I was with Liliana, right? Because with Lily, she'd shifted crowds in school. We went to the same high school, but like we didn't talk, we didn't have the same classes. But I still went over to her house, which was awkward, because I was there to speak with her sibling. It was just a weird situation. But Jane came to me, and we sat down on her bed, and she said, "I don't think I'm a girl. I've always felt wrong, like there was something off." When I asked her what she meant by that, she said, "I'm a guy. I think that this is something that's important, something that needs to change. I need to start changing." And for the first time since I'd met her, other than when faced with cheesy romance television shows that I forced her to watch, she looked scared. So, of course, I said, "If you need my help, I'll be here. I'm happy that you've found out a piece of yourself and that you're really thinking about this and thinking about what can make you happy." Transitioning is not as easy as people make it out to be. And even if they don't make it out to be easy, they don't exactly talk about it because it's not something that's generally accepted to be talked about, except within the people that do transition. So if you were just their friend or their, like, I don't know, like a friend of a friend, you wouldn't really get to hear about it, you wouldn't know. But the mood swings, the crashes, the downs, not knowing if it was the right choice, not knowing if people would accept them, it was a tough time. It wasn't a situation where they went through like gender fluidity or being non-binary. They just knew once they'd seen like other trans people, they were like, that makes sense. I feel that way, and that's important. And as I sat by his side through those lows, through those rough times, he always came out okay. He got more confident, he got more brilliant. And everything just seemed to change for the better, of course. I got to watch as he started to love himself, how he looked, how he could act, and he started to love himself for who he was. Of course, still having periods, this guy really sucked. Still does. Hormone treatments and all of it is, it was just such an experience, and being able to be by their side through that is just, it's such a special moment, you know, because that trust to be able to come to you and be like, hey, this is something that really matters to me, and I want you to be here while I discover this new version of myself. That makes you feel really special. And we talked, we kept talking, hanging out. There were some times where we didn't hang out as much, and those times were harder. I saw their friends come and go, and I saw some leave them on purpose because of this. But he never backed down. He never stopped because he knew that this was a part of who he was, and it was what he needed to do. And when he got to the point where he was happy, I was happy. And that was just it. That was all I thought about. He was happy now, and I was happy that he was happy. I say that like it's a bad thing. His happiness is amazing. And then a couple days after that, I'm missing a very important step here. I, over the years, been in and out of a few relationships, quite a few, but more recently they've been getting longer and longer, until one of them which wasn't even as long as the one before it, shook me up a bit. For the majority of it, it was great. Everything about it was great. He was great. But that relationship did end up hurting me a lot. Not because of how it was initially, but because near the end, he didn't have time for me. And that's not really good for a relationship. Especially for someone like me who needs that attention. So I stayed by him. I stayed by his side. I talked to him. I tried to keep up with him and get his attention and make sure he was doing okay. And it didn't work out. So for a couple months, I was essentially in a one-sided relationship that wasn't even deemed a relationship. And then I didn't feel beautiful anymore. I didn't love myself, I didn't care. I legitimately felt like I was a burden. Like I didn't feel like I could make anyone feel like they were lucky to have me. Because if anything, I was a negative. I would just end up hurting someone. So why fall in love in the first place, you know? Which is not a good outlook to have. So when that ended, I sort of shut down without realizing it. I tried to continue on being exactly as I did. I lost some friendships. I couldn't talk to the people that care for me, that I care about. And it was just difficult. I genuinely did not love myself anymore. So a couple days after now Jay finished his treatments, well, the majority of them, and got to a place where he felt comfortable and he felt stable. It was about a week and a half after I ended things for good, which was about a month or 2 months after things initially ended with that previous person who did not make me feel beautiful anymore. And Jay, sweetheart that he is, came up to me like it was natural. And brought me Mike and Ike's Jolly Ranchers and gummy bears. He handed them to me. And I said, thank you, what are these for? And he said, oh, nothing. And then he walked away. The next day, of course, he came back, right? And he said, actually, I was planning to ask you out after that. But I sort of chickened out. And of course I went, wait, what? What do you mean? And then we became a thing. Around that time, a couple weeks before, probably maybe a month before, they had started up that band I mentioned, and I get to sing in it sometimes. I'm mostly a guest, but They've invited me to be a permanent member of the band multiple times. However, I just think relationships in bands is not the best thing. And if I join that band, they deserve to have all of me, you know? Not just whatever I can give right now, because I am super busy. They're a good band, and I want to be able to listen to them and play with them, sing with them, be an actual member, and to do that, I would need the time, which I don't have right now, so I turned them down. But I still get to on occasion. They invite me often, and it's a lot of fun when I do. Mostly goofing around, because they're not doing anything super professional, like recording it, anything like that. They play at local venues, they make videos that they keep amongst themselves and show to friends. They played at like this really small thing. I'm trying to remember the name, which is why I'm stuttering so much, but it's like it was at a park and they were talking, and then they just sort of said, "Hey, you wanna play here?" And they didn't, like, someone approached them. It was cool. I don't know. I was told the story like 3 times and I still don't remember it. I need a cough. Woo. Okay. I love being able to meet myself. I wish I could meet myself in real life, that would be great. Okay, so what got me thinking about this, right? Well, recently they said, "Hey, do you wanna design a cover? We've put a bunch of our songs on CDs for you, and we wanna put it in a CD case that you've designed so we can give it to you so you can play it in your car." Which of course melted my heart, because I have a CD player in a car, because my car's from 98. Like, it's an old car, but it's very nice. It's very well taken care of, and I love it, and it's great. And the fact that they would think about that is just really cool. So, listening to this music always makes me slow down and leave a lot of pauses in between my words, which I'm concerned about sometimes, but that's okay. So, they showed me a new song. Now that tears in my eyes. Let's pretend it's from yawning, okay? I shouldn't have said it. But essentially it was like, "We're gonna knock your socks off." I said, "I'm not wearing socks." So they had me unzip my boots and show them, and I'm like, "I'm not wearing socks. So we're gonna knock your boots off." And I said, "Okay." And it was amazing, so yeah. But when they went to get their drinks in the kitchen, Jay stayed behind and said, "As far as I can tell, your boots are still on your feet." So he came over, unzipped and took off my boots, and then threw them across the room. Not super hard, but he threw them across the room very dramatically and said, "Now we can say we knocked your boots off." I was then promptly placed in his lap, and we chilled, and it was great. a big grin on my face. I hope you can see it. It's great. I mean, you can't... you can't see it, obviously. But you can... You know it's there now. Which is great. So... Yeah. Second topic. I've been going to the park more recently. Like, after I'm done doing something, if I'm out, I'll probably end up stopping by one of the parks nearby. Specifically one park that has more of my, of the, playground equipment than the other one. And it's the park that I went to most often when I was little. So it has a lot of memories, and I know all the best ways to push the merry-go-round, to hang upside down from the monkey bars, to slide down that little swirly thing on that pole. I don't know what it's called. What are you, it's like a fireman's pole, but like there's a little extra pole that goes on a swirl downwards, and you put your thighs on the pole and you just turn around and around and around. You gotta hold yourself on the main pole, like in the middle, with your hands, or you'll just fly off it. So, but I went there tonight, it was raining. I went down to the park, I walked around, it was great. It was just beautiful. Though there was this like group of really sus people at the park dancing around, and they bolted when like a family showed up from their hike. So they might have been doing something illegal, but I can't testify to it, so no one called me in. I've been learning more songs because of the band thing, not just in general. Since the musical was a more recent addition, I showed it to my mum, and we showed it to my sister, and then we're going to show it to the lady whose kids I babysit sometimes, specifically the two little boys that I love so much. They're so well behaved, and we once played tag for 4 hours because they were just so much fun. So the plan is I'm going to watch the kids, and then we're going to put them to bed, and when they go to bed, the adults are going to come back. I'm an adult now, too, that's weird. But like, the adults are going to come back. We're going to chill, and we're going to watch Six and see how it goes. How exciting. I've been writing more often, because I, which is like, I've been writing again, I guess, I should say, because I took a break from writing for a while, and reading, and then I got back into reading, and then I got back into writing. I love writing because it's like, you get to create your whole new worlds, and I have 4 walls covered in bookshelves, just like filled top to bottom with books that I wrote, so I feel special. I joined the Alumi, I think it is, just Alumi, right? Let me check. Alumni. See, it's alumni, but we call it Alu, and Alumni. See, it's supposed to be like alumni. Is the word, but I don't know if she just misspelled it. But it's technically the alumni SMP, but it's Alumni, I think. So, yeah, I joined that. It's interesting. We're creating lore. To give you some background, my character, also named Al, so it's easier. The whole thing with her is, at least for me, that so she's looking for love because she's heard it makes people happy, but she's also heard like very little else about it, so she's trying to learn what it means. And she ends up asking like moms for aid, that she's very unsuccessful with. But the whole thing behind love is that she's never really felt it. She doesn't know what it's like. So she's searching for that feeling that everyone seems to love. Like, everyone seems to like that feeling. She doesn't know what love is. She's like, hey, this is so cool. Let's figure out what it is. This is gonna be great as soon as I figure out what it is. So that's a part of it. The others seem to be developing lore very well. It's doing great. I've been designing a lot more recently, as you can see from the new scene on Twitch. It's great. My outfits have changed recently with my confidence boost that comes from being in a relationship. My hair, I have let it curl sometimes, which doesn't happen often. But I do now let it sometimes. Not all the time, but sometimes. My voice is so dry, I need to just swallow. Okay. My voice is really a mess, so my friends are celebrating a birthday party later tonight, so I'll have to end stream to go to that. Well, I'll have to end stream to move again to another room when my mum and sister come back, because my sister's home from college, my mum is off on a break because it's the weekend, it's great. So when they come back, they're gonna watch a video in the media room, like the living room, and then after that they're gonna come into this room, so I'll move into that room again because I moved out for them. So that'll be fun, and then I'll probably listen to some music, write a bit, or like play on the SMP, and then at around like 10 maybe, I'll head into VC where we'll be celebrating a friend's birthday. Happy birthday, Travis. But I've changed a lot, I know, because someone who I used to hate, I don't anymore, for one thing. But she also is now a close friend of mine. And she tells me that I give off fairy vibes, which I very much appreciate. I love the fact that I give off fairy vibes. Another thing that sort of brought this upon me, I was cleaning out my room recently, so all that sort of stuff, and then around the house. So we went through all the shoes, which I don't have many shoes, but I got like 2 new pairs of shoes because people didn't want their shoes. And we went through the mugs, and I realized, hey, I don't think I have a single cup in this house that is exclusively mine, because, you know, people get other people gifts, and it's like mugs sometimes, and that's like their mug, but like, other people use it because it's not a designated mug thing, because we have so many mugs. I'm rambling, but I didn't have a single one, so I was like, hey, I'm not in charge of this. This is crazy. I do the dishes here. But that was sort of eye-opening in a way. Getting rid of some things, remembering that I have some things. It's just crazy. Especially like in a time so full of change when my sister's at college. First time. It's insane. So she's adapting to a new way of life and I'm really changing. We recently, on a break, like a vacation, took a vacation, went up to Ohio, where some family is, and we went there to visit my grandmother, my step-grandmother on my mum's side, and because she has cancer, she took care of my grandfather on my mum's side, who died of cancer, and she took care of him until he died, and then planned his funeral and took care of that and all of it, and in doing so she'd put off her own like medical checks So she was planning to come down here where we are and just chill out, go to this lake house that they often went to visit us. And to do that, she had to go to the doctor, right? And that's where they found out that she had cancer, a different kind of cancer. So she'd been getting treatment, and we went up to visit her, see how she's doing, and she seemed to be doing really well, except for some swelling in her legs, which then turned out to be a problem when a few hours later, when we were at my mum's brother, my uncle's house for the night, we got a call like, oh, grandma went to the ER, like, that's not a good thing, but she went to urgent care, and that was a bit much. It was overwhelming, but then we ended up staying longer than anticipated for a funeral. My great-grandfather on my father's side died, so I went to a funeral and supported my grandmother on my dad's side, and met a bunch of people I hadn't seen in a while, and I went to my first funeral, which was interesting. And that was in the night, and then the next morning we were gonna go to the morning service. So my sister and I get in the car, I was in the passenger seat, she in the driver's seat, and we head out to McDonald's. And on our way back to the house to eat like breakfast, because my mum wanted McDonald's breakfast, we get in a collision. This guy was a snowplow, because it had unexpectedly snowed, they weren't prepared for it, there was no salt on the roads, he was snowplowing driveways, he backed right into the passenger door of our car. It was a lot, but I couldn't freak out because my sister has anxiety, and if I freaked out, she would freak out and possibly have a panic attack and die. So I didn't do that. I did really well, and I calmed the situation down, called my mum, who works in auto collisions, and everything was fine. It's just a really stressful trip, and we didn't end up going to the morning service because I was in a glen. I've been changing up my schedule recently so that I can do some things that I want to do. I have to regulate my own schedule now that I have a car and can drive it and license and everything, which I should probably be used to by now, but it might take me like a few years before I get used to having a license and everything, like a few more years, like, you know. Something I find surprising is that I often surprise people with my manners, with being kind. And that's like letting people in like when I'm driving, like zippering correctly, just saying good morning, smiling at people as I pass, that sort of stuff. It seems to really shock some people that I do that. They're just like, you're so nice. I'm like, no, this is common decency. What kind of people do you hang out with? But recently I went to the library. I go to the library most mornings, but not this week, of course, but like usually before I have to buckle down and work things, do busy stuff, I'll go to the library. And at the library there was this book, right? It's an etiquette book, like a manners book, and I thought it would be so boring, but then I read it and I'm like, this is hilarious. So the more I read it, and it's intentionally hilarious too, which is great. So I have that book now, and I have checked it out, and it's mine, and I'm gonna read it forever. But I'm totally gonna buy that book because it's amazing, and I'll have to look at the title so that I can send it in the Discord so that you guys can check it out, because it's amazing and I love it. If you remember, random thought. If you remember, when I went out to the park this evening, it was raining, right? I have a newfound love for the rain. I hated the rain, especially while learning to drive. But before that, I didn't really like the rain because it meant I couldn't do anything. I couldn't go out. I didn't like it. Now I like the rain because I can go out in it. I can play in the rain. All of it. And I have a newfound love not just for the rain, but for myself. And that's definitely thanks to him. I really did think for the longest time after that relationship ended that if I were to get in a relationship with someone, I would only hurt them. I don't want to hurt people. I'm not worth being around. I'm a bad person. I'm just a burden. I'm not beautiful. I'm not even pretty. I'm overweight. I'm just the ugliest thing ever, you know? But that's not true. If anything, I have curves. I'm skinny, but I have curves. I'm hot as hell. I have fun. And I'm not a burden. As much as I felt like one, I am not a burden. And if it weren't for Jay, I wouldn't know that. Which is definitely something that sounds unhealthy. But it's how my brain works. If I don't have something to confirm that, hey, yeah, you're a good person. You're beautiful, you're smart. You're great, you're brave, all of that. I wouldn't believe it. So, having someone to be there and say those things is just really nice. I'm not sure what else I want to say, to be honest. I've been talking for about 50 minutes by now. And you're probably tired of hearing me jabber on. I don't know. Who's been watching this long? It couldn't be me, could it? Could it? Hold on. Tell me that wasn't it, right? Okay, that's not it. Someone is him. I don't know what's happening. But thank you for being here and listening to all of this. It's a lot of very, like, I don't want to say, it's like, some of it's serious, some of it's nice, but it's not exactly like prime content. I just wanted to fill everyone in, get some talking out, get a real grasp on how things are, and the plan is to end this stream at 1 hour, so you know how it goes. We're gonna talk for about another 4 minutes, and then we're gonna switch over to the ending stream fun. Yeah. Oof. Blue. People are confusing. I don't know. This is all, it's all crazy. I think that this is actually a better time to switch over, since the music seems to be the main contributor here. Love you guys so much. Thank you for joining me. I hope that you had a great time. And now it'll be time to it to be time. The time to end this stream. I love you all. Bye. Have fun listening to the music.
I can't. was running far away. Will I run off the world someday? Nobody knows, nobody knows. I was dancing in the rain. I felt a love and I can't complain. But now I'm
too. I'll run off the world someday. Nobody knows, nobody knows. I was dancing in the rain. I felt a love and I can't complain. But now I'll take me home.
You cut out a piece of me, and now I bleed internally. Life here without you, without you. And it hurts for me to think about what life could possibly be like without you, without you. I can't believe that you wouldn't believe me. Fuck all of your reasons, I lost my shit. You know I didn't mean it, now I see it. I can't take it back, so in the past is where we leave it all. So there you go, oh, come and go out of the blue, no. And I'll never find the words to say I'm sorry, but I'm scared to be alone. You cut out a piece of me, and now I bleed internally. Life here without you, without you. For me to get by what life could possibly be like without you, without you.